Good evening, everyone, and welcome to the Thompson Arena here on Mustangs TV. We're just about to watch Rock the Rink 2011 in this men's hockey university CIS matchup between the Laurier Golden Hawks and your University of Western Ontario Mustangs. My name is Andrew Buddy, alongside my color commentator, Andrew Evans. Brendan Gibbons is my color commentator in St. Thomas, but you are my color commentator here, Andrew. And we are expecting what will be a great game against the number four team in the country and the number one team here in the OUA West, the Western Mustangs. Andrew, what should we expect today?
We should expect a great matchup. Both teams coming in. Should be a great game. Western Mustangs coming off a big win last night in St. Catharines there over the Brock Badgers, coming out on top in that one 5-1. They'll be riding the momentum off that win, coming in obviously to a packed house for Rock the Rink tonight. They're going to have the fan support for them. It's going to be a great show. I'm worried about these Laurier Golden Hawks. I think they're in for a tough one.
And Laurier right now is currently sitting in fourth place in the OUA West, but they always have a chance when they're facing the UWO Mustangs. They're currently 14-0-3 with that win last night, so obviously undefeated in regular time, as we're going to send it down to the rink for our pregame ceremonies and O Canada. Once again, welcome to Thompson Arena, Rock the Rink 2011. As we have our ceremonial puck drop, Josh Eunice is going to get the starting goal today for the University of Western Ontario Mustangs. Starting a goal, Ryan Daniels for the Laurier Golden Hawks, as we see Nemeth for the Mustangs take the face-off. And this house is packed tonight. It is a great game. It's going to be a great game. And we have the band going. We have a rock band as well. We have everything that we need. Now all we need is a game. Andrew?
Yeah, definitely. You said it there, Andrew. They were able to sell about 3,000 tickets for the game tonight. As you said, great setup here at Thompson Arena. And they're definitely going to be treated to quite the matchup here. Laurier Golden Hawks 9-4 coming in against the undefeated in regular time, the Western Mustangs. So these fans are definitely in for a treat. Looking up at the lineups for tonight's game, obviously the Western Mustangs without number 13 Kyle Lamb for tonight's game. He's one of the leading scorers for the Mustangs this season with 12 goals and 8 assists, good for 20 points. So they'll have to look further down the bench a bit maybe this evening. Referee's just about set to start the game.
Risk wins the faceoff for the Golden Hawks. And we're off and running here in Rock the Rink 2011 here at Thompson Arena at the University of Western Ontario campus. Reed sends that one into the corner. In behind the net. Killing takes down his man behind the net. And there's an early penalty coming up here, and it's going to go to the Western Mustangs.
Tripping penalty there.
It's going to go to Kevin Baker of the Stangs.
So right away, the Mustangs go to the penalty kill. Going to have to kill off the two-minute minor here. 30 seconds into play. Face-off in the Western zone.
Face-off scrambled, goes into the corner. It's quickly sent in front, but knocked down there. Sent over to the right point. There's a shot. Great save there by Eunice. Rebound goes wide of the net. Bernard fakes a slap shot. Still's got the puck. Risk. Now backhand back to the captain. Risk. There's a wrist shot. That's off the crossbar and goes high above the net and out of play.
Golden Hawks with a nice power play setup in the Western zone so far, passing around very nicely.
Furlong to take the face off for the Stangs. He loses it though. It goes down to Sinfield. Down over to Good. Good gets checked and back comes the Stangs. Reese loses the puck there to one of the Golden Hawks. And it's back in Laurier territory.
1 minute remaining on the power play for the Golden Hawks.
Wrapped around into the Stang zone. Seinfeld. Now back into the corner. Back to the point. Sinfield. Nardi fakes the slap shot back to Sinfield. There's a wrist shot. Nice save by Eunice. Rebound goes into the corner. Stangs have a chance to clear, and they will.
Clear it down the ice with 30 seconds now left on that early power play for the Golden Hawks. The Mustangs coming out very strong on the penalty kill in the early get going here.
Daniels left that one for Sinfeld. And in come the Laurier Golden Hawks. That one's kept in there. Just for a moment though, the Stangs will clear out in the last 7 seconds of this Laurier penalty. Power play. Bellows sends that one into the corner. The Stangs are full strength. That one's chipped out into the neutral ice area. Killing. Down in into the corner to Sittamore. He loses the puck. It's chipped out and Bellows has it now. He couldn't reach the loose puck and it's sent right back into Laurier territory.
Back to even strength now with the Mustangs penalty being killed off. 3 minutes into the action here at Thompson Arena for Rock the Rink 2011 between the Golden Hawks from Laurier and the Western Mustangs.
Out come the Stags. Rocca, he is a former St. Thomas Star of the Junior B GOJHL League. Rocca loses the puck, but it's quickly picked up there. Sent down around the point down. Low. Oh, geez, looks as though there was a bit of a hold there, but Laurier gets away with it and is sent deep into the Stangs territory. Rocca picks that one up, gives it to McKee. McKee dumps that one in. Daniels is out there for Laurier and net to chip that one down into the corner. That one hits off the referee. And out come the Golden Hawks. Down the right wing side, that shot's tipped up into the netting and out of play.
Face-off coming up just to the right, it looks like, of the Western goalie. Tonight, Josh Eunice in net for the Mustangs.
Face one of the zone. Trying to pick that one up. He stumbled, though, and then sent right back into Western territory. Now Furlong dumps that one off to his teammate. The two brothers out there. Two Furlongs on this team today, and that's Sean Furlong and Jason Furlong. Sent in front, wide open there, but no one to put it home for the Stags. Stags asking for too many men on the ice there as Laurier got caught with the sloppy change, but nothing was being called. Ray got that one back. It's slapped into Western territory. Arson there, the former London Knight. Tried to send that one out to Hannigan. He'll go the other way, though, and wrap it all the way around the boards. This one's back to Arson. Killing. Sends it up ice, and they'll dump it in. Hannigan goes chasing after it. Killing. Sent down low. In front shot, rebound, goes wide of the net. Sent back to the point. Killing. Over to Arson. Scott Arson winds up, fakes a shot, up back over to Killing. Killing takes a wrist shot. That one stopped by Daniels, and it goes into the corner. Killing keeps it in. Killing, slap shot, goes wide of the net. That one sent in front, stolen by the Golden Hawks, and they'll relieve some pressure here by getting some changes. Good pressure by the Stangs there in that sequence, and they're going to come right back up with it. Killing will dump it in. He'll go off for a change.
Great pace in the early goings here at Thompson Arena. Mustangs coming off a game last night.
Williams.
Against Brock University. Winners 5-1.
Williams had sent that one in front. That was a close chance there for the Golden Hawks. Nemeth will send that one in for the Stags. Back out comes the Golden Hawks. Bellows leaves that one. He'll go off for a change. .13-23 remaining here in this fast-paced first period.
The officials definitely letting the boys play tonight. Not too many whistles so far in the first period here.
Skinner had shot that one wide. It came off a Western Mustang and went into the corner. Now the Golden Hawks applying some pressure as that one was sent in front. Went loose though, and Rocca now has it. It's one against the world as he had three men on him. That one will go offside. For a whistle with 12:50 remaining here in the first period, you're watching Western Mustangs TV. Brought to Rink 2011.
Every day.
And the Laurier Golden Hawks and the Western Mustangs. Andrew, your take on this first couple of minutes here in this first period.
Well, like I was saying to you, they're great pace so far. The referee's definitely letting the boys play it out. Western definitely not showing any rust after big road win last night up at Brock University. So great pace from both teams so far. Possibly the early edge goes to the Mustangs. They've had a few scoring opportunities, but Laurier hit a post earlier in the period. So both teams flying out of the gates, that's for sure.
McKee tried to keep that one in. He couldn't. Now sent back into the Stang zone as Zachary Ray of the Colton Hawks will go off. He was an early addition to the roster. Sorry, a late addition to the roster there for the Golden Hawks. He's not even wearing a name on the back of his shirt. Smith lost that one. Rocca picks it up. He lost it. Sent off the boards and back to Killing. Killing runs some interference. Sent into the neutral zone where Reese is battling for it. In come the Golden Hawks. Shepley sends that one back to the point. There's a shot. That one's blocked. Goes back down to Sinfeld. That one's dumped in. And Killing will go back for it. He'll pick it up from Eunice. That one goes off of a Golden Hawk. No icing called in. Just caught there was Daniels. And he almost wasn't able to make that save on Furlong. There's a shot now. That one saved by Daniels. He'll pick it up with 11:18 remaining here in this first period.
Everybody clap your hands.
Well, one team is going to see an unbeaten streak come to an end tonight. Laurier comes in riding a six-game unbeaten streak that dated back, of course, to before Christmas break for the students. And, of course, the Western Mustangs, undefeated in regulation on the season. They come in, obviously, with the 13 regulation victories and the three OT losses. So definitely a good matchup for tonight's action.
Obviously, some pressure on both teams for that exact reason, Andrew, but even more, I think, pressure on the Stangs. There's got to be pressure every game. You know, you add one brick to the shoulder every time because of this unbeaten streak, and you don't want to let that go. It's almost like a kill of momentum, if you might say that, in their season. If you let that one loss, obviously it's not that big of a dent in their standings or whatever it may be. They're well in first, and they're doing well, but one loss, and you never know what will happen to a season. So they really want to keep this momentum going, and obviously they're 14-0-3.
Yeah, exactly. Hey, every game's important. Win, lose, or, well, no ties anymore. But as you said, one loss can certainly add up. So, I mean, the three OT losses definitely hurt, but obviously that unbeaten streak still alive for regulation time for the Mustangs.
Paltridge is back in the neutral zone. He had lost that puck. As the Golden Hawks are trying to apply some pressure here, but the Stangs jump out here. A little bit of a slash there as
we'll get to
Baker
a whistle here and possible call.
Baker had lost the stick. McQuaid bumps into his man. That seemed as though that was
Alexander Bolter is going to serve 2 minutes, looks like, for the slash.
Face off to the right of Daniels. Face off one. By the Stangs, Killing on the right defense position, keeps that one in, sent it down to Reese, he lost it, it'll come off the boards awkwardly, and out right back to Eunice. Josh Eunice, the 6-0 goaltender in his second year at Western from Holland, Ohio. McKee dumps that one in, he goes to chase after it himself. So Coulter gets 2 minutes for slashing, and the Stangs only have a minute 19 remaining here. They haven't got anything set up yet.
We're going to get, looks to be an offside call on the Mustangs. First chance on the power play this evening for Western. And the way pace of this game has gone so far, look for plenty of chances with 1:16 remaining on the power play.
Face off, goes all the way down the ice. And out come the Stangs with only a minute 5 remaining here in this power play. Nemeth sends it in around the boards. Hit hard there in the corner there. And Snow sends it in behind the net. Dumped off the boards, kept in though there by Nemeth. Sent into the middle. back to Scott Arson. Arson gives that one to Turk Weiss. Back to Arson. Arson to Nemeth. Nemeth back to Arson. Arson. There's a shot. Good save there by Daniels, who's been standing tall on that net so far for the Laurier Golden Hawks.
Yeah, definitely the Western Mustangs having killed off the early penalty that they were assessed early in the period. Now here they are applying pressure to the Golden Hawks on their own power play. 34 seconds left remaining in that power play for the Mustangs.
Nemeth comes loose to him at the point. Kept in, oh, just barely came out. Scott Arson couldn't keep it in from the pass from Nemeth.
The London, Ontario native Scott Arson, formerly of the London Knights, in his second year here at Western University.
Farmanara scrambles that draw, goes all the way down to the Stang zone. Yunus will stay in his net as he leaves it for Arson. With only 17 seconds remaining here in the Stang's power play, another turnover there by Farmanara, and it'll go right back into the Western zone. Out come the Stangs. Snow has that one stolen by Alacock. He shoots. That goes wide of the net. Yunus got a piece of it. Smith dumps that one off the boards. Can't get it out. The penalty's over to Laurier. And now Alacock seems to be almost sprung there as he takes out there his man. And it's cleared out to the neutral zone area. There will be a little calm in the action here.
Western looking to regroup a bit there. A few poor giveaways as the power play came to an end. Mustangs behind the net now coming out.
Sidamore sends that one in. Smith had that play offside, and it'll be calling with 7:11 remaining here in the first period.
With the faceoff in the neutral zone.
Furlong. That was Jason Furlong, one of the brothers, wins that faceoff, but quickly come back to Laurier Golden Hawks. Sean Furlong sends that one over, and the Stangs will regroup. That pass intended for Furlong was stolen. Back comes Fellows. He sends it across. Yunus was there to cover it, but no need as it went right back to the Stangs. Here's Furlong. Sent that one across. Tied up in the...
And that came off as the Western player slid into the crease there. We'll have a whistle.
No hard feelings either as Daniels gives a pat to the Stangs forward.
.644 remaining here in the opening period between the Golden Hawks and the Mustangs. Rock the Ring 2011 here at Thompson Arena.
There is a penalty coming up now. Another slashing call is going to come.
This one going to, it looks to be...
Laurier.
Laurier.
It was Turk Weiss who had his stick chopped from him. And going off.
That looks to be Ryan Bernardi heading to the box for the Golden Hawks. Western will look to continue their pressure from the earlier power play in the period.
That one sent low. Arson takes a slap shot. That one saved by Daniels. That one goes way up in the air with a rebound. That one sent out to the blue line, just out. Arson gets tripped up there in the neutral zone. So Arson and Nemeth on defense, both getting a lot of ice time here in the first period here as they've been on the power play. I think this is their third time now. Arson takes a slap shot, again, right into the crest of Daniels. So really nothing testing Daniels early as they've taken a couple of shots, but really they've gone right into the crest of Ryan Daniels.
The official storage Mustangs are definitely going to want to look to get a bit of traffic in front of Daniels. Obviously, as you said, he's been seeing making the point-blank saves so far this evening.
Killing had that pass tip. Smeet gets that one back to Killing, and they'll regroup. Killing down to Smeet. He sends it in to the right side corner. Reese wins that puck. Looking back to Killing, he keeps it for himself. Reese sends that one down low. Baker down to Reese. He takes a shot. That one saved by Daniels. It comes right back to Reese. He'll send it down. Baker. Baker walks in. That shot's blocked. And this one's sent down the ice as pass one astray, and Killing will send it right back in. 40 seconds remaining here on the Stangs power play. Killing takes a slap shot again right into the crest of Daniels. No traffic in front. He scoops that one in.
36 seconds remaining in the power play for the Mustangs. Although they've had their chances out front, they have not been able to muster up any offense.
Faceoff scramble goes back to the line. Kept in there by Arson. Arson blocks that one, keeps it in for a moment. Then sent all the way down the ice where Eunice is there to pick it up for Nemeth.
20 seconds remaining in the power play. With 5 minutes remaining in the first period.
That one sent in the corner. Snow. Sent in front and sent all the way down the ice. Once again, Eunice will pick it up. And that should do it for this Laurier penalty and Western Mustangs power play. Bellows sends that one in. There's a loose puck in front. Slap shot right in front of Eunice. But he...
Eunice hasn't seen too much action in front of him so far in the opening period. 4:35 left.
Face off to the left of Eunice.
Mustangs win that draw, and the puck out into the neutral zone and dumped back into the western zone for icing, it looks to be.
So McGill is leading Ottawa. Lincoln's beating Windsor 1-0.
Of course, the big matchup next weekend here in London with Lakehead University between the Mustangs and Lakehead.
And that's the Jack Frost Cup next Saturday here at Thompson Arena. They tell you to get those tickets early because they did go pretty quick. Bellows takes a wrist shot. Nice glove save there by Eunice.
That's a doubleheader next weekend with Lakehead. Game here at Thompson Arena on Friday and Saturday night. Puck drops slated for 7:30 both evenings. So we have another face-off in the western zone. Just to the...
Sinfeld sends that one around the boards. And Smeet will send that one up to Reese. Reese is up. Furlong sends it to his brother. Furlong gets taken out hard there. And Reese will try a backhander. Goes wide of the net. Jason Furlong lost the puck, goes back to the point, kept in momentarily. John Furlong sends that one in front. There's another wrist shot, again saved by Daniels.
But he's falling all over the place in the Laurier zone there.
Eunice is there to pick it up for the Stangs. Reese tried to reach that pass. He couldn't reach it, though. Sent around the boards, not out. Nice hit there along the boards as Smeet is throwing his weight around. The referee gets him in the way a bit. Reese still shoving his man to the ground now as that one sent in front. Couldn't get a shot off.
Smeet being roughed up there along the boards. He'll go to the bench. Looks Sean, to be fine.
Sean Furlong dumps that one in. The Stangs will get some much needed subs going. Zachary Ray gets taken out there. He loses the puck in the neutral zone for Laurier as that one's dumped in to the right of Daniels. Tumbling over there as one of the Stangs forwards. It's sent around. Killing trying to keep it in. He lays a hit there on Ray. And out comes Laurier. They'll dump it in, getting a few more changes in. Baker loses the puck there. It's sent in front. Backhand gets blocked initially. Back to the point. Gauthier tried a shot. That one was blocked. Now looking in front. Gauthier tries a shot. That one goes wide of the net. Out come the Stangs.
Two minutes left in the opening period here.
Turquoise lays a hit there on his man.
Oh, okay.
Now he's stuck. His stick is stuck, but out come the Stangs. There's a shot. Nice save by Daniels with the glove hand. Reed sends out one up to Risk. Risk takes his man out hard into the boards. That's Nemeth. Nemeth dumped it around the boards. He'll get it right back, though. As the physical play starts to turn up here. Baker and Turquoise poking at the puck for the Stangs. Baker will send it over to the other side where McQuaid is there. And he dumps it in. That one's loose in front. Back to the point. Kept in. There were two Stangs there, but they miscommunicated with each other. Back to the point. McQuaid takes a wrist shot. That one's blocked. Initially, now back. It's loose in front. No one can seem to get a stick on it. Back to Nemeth. Nemeth over to McQuaid. There's a wrist shot. That one's blocked. McQuaid once again. There's a wrist shot again. That one goes wide of the net. Nemeth. Sorry, that was Greenside over on the left side defense. Not McQuaid. And Eunice will leave it there for him. As Rocca tries to poke at it, he tries to get into the zone. Laurier will try to get it out, though. Bernard
time
tried
winding
to
down here in the first period. Just under 10 seconds remaining in the play.
Alec Gock will send it the rest of the way. 4 seconds remaining. That should do it here in the first period of play. And we'll be scoreless. No goals here in the first period. And we'll wait for Kathleen Campbell-Conlin.
Great opening 20 from both teams. Western with plenty of action in the early going. Plenty of chances for both teams. A few power plays. And both head coaches have to be fairly happy with the pace of play so far in the first period. We're at Thompson Arena on the University of Western Ontario campus for Rock the Rink 2011 between the Western Mustangs men's hockey team and the visiting Laurier Golden Hawks. 0-0 after the first period.
We thought we would have a interview down there with Kathleen Campbell-Conlin, but I don't think she found who she was looking for.
Andrew, while we have a break here as we try to figure things out, what was your take on the opening period?
Opening period, you know what? The Stangs gained most of the possession there, obviously coming off of most of the penalties they've had in the period, but they haven't tested Daniels, who is in goal, and that is my take on it, is that they need to test Daniels more, getting traffic in front, doing better in that sort of way. Every shot they've had so far, it's been right into the crest of Daniels, so let's see if they can test the goalie a bit more in the second period.
Yeah, definitely have to agree with you on that one. They're getting their shots, just nothing in front. Now, had a few power plays in the first period there. Penalty kill and power play, of course. The special teams, do you think that will be a key factor in tonight's matchup between the two teams?
It's tough to say because really the Stangs have been the only one on the power play so far. It's been the clumsy slashes so far of Laurier that have gotten into some penalty trouble. So if it wasn't for that, there wouldn't have been so much. But you know what? If we can keep this one clean, I don't think penalties should be that much of a factor. We'll see. You never know what a game will bring, what kind of physical play we'll see. And we'll see what the third period brings. But again, if it's someone's penalty kill, right now it's Laurier's that needs to step up. And it's also Western's that needs to step up when they get called upon, because I don't think they've been called upon this game yet.
Yeah, not so much. They've been going about their fight so far. Obviously, this one's shaping up to be quite different from the earlier matchup between the two teams back on October 22nd, where the Western Mustangs were all over Laurier, winning 7-2 that night back in October. So with two periods left to play here, may have a different result from that game.
As we're watching the shootout here, down on the ice, and we'll be back with your second period of play in just about 11 minutes. We'll let you watch the rest of the intermission, and we'll get it going right after this. You're watching Western Mustangs Hockey right here on Mustangs TV. Right here on Mustangs TV. Welcome back. I'm Andrew Buttigieg alongside my color commentator, Andrew Evans. What a first period we saw, but scoreless first period nonetheless.
Yeah, that's right, Andrew. No goals in the first period. A couple power plays and some fairly good scoring opportunities for both teams. Daniels bring on a bit of a show in net for the Laurier Golden Hawks as the Mustangs controlled the play in the opening frame as they win the opening faceoff.
Here come the Western Mustangs early. Baker sends that one cross ice into the center. That one's deflected off a Laurier defender and goes back into the Stangs zone where Scott Arson is there to pick it up. Here come the Stangs. Arson try to complete a pass there. It was blocked, but it goes into the corner for Turquoise. Turquoise still chasing after. Again, it's cleared out. This will go for an icing call. Again, no touch icing here in CIS action, so that one will go back to the right of Daniels for a face-off. Both teams will make some changes with 19-19 remaining in the first period, second period.
I think the Mustangs' biggest problem in the first period was not getting enough traffic in front of Daniels in net for the Golden Hawks. Let's see if they try to bring a bit more traffic in front during the second period for him.
Simidor lost that one as Farmanara got a bit of an elbow into the face.
A packed house here at Thompson Arena tonight for Rock the Rink 2011.
No doubt, packed rink indeed. And from your angle that you're watching on the camera, you're probably seeing the other side, which is, you know, it's packed, but it's not full. But if you see the close side here, it is full of people, and I don't think there's barely any seats left on this side of the arena. So a good turnout for this and well promoted by the Western staff. This one's sent around the boards. Skinner is there waiting for it. He'll lose it. Reese picks that one up for the Stangs. Reese in around the net, gets taken down, and out come the Golden Hawks. Furlong gets hit there. He leaves it for McQuaid, who loses it in turn. Alacock, he takes a slap shot. Great glove, blocker save there by Yunus. Comes right back out to the point. Wrist shot goes wide of the net. Smeet comes right back out for the Stangs. Smeet carries it in through the neutral zone. He dumps it in, but not all the way, though. It was cleared right back down the ice. Going for an icing. Actually, no icing. It was waved off. And the Stangs are back with three forward strong. Reese goes into forecheck. He takes his man out. Goes around the boards. Golden Hawks trying to get it out, but it's kept in there by Furlong. Reese dumps it in behind the net. Furlong goes chasing after it. He loses the puck. Arson keeps that one in. Furlong trying to chase after it. It's picked up there by a Laurier defender and sent out as Ray misses that pass. So it'll go out for an icing.
About 2.5 minutes into the second period here at Thompson Arena. Both teams off to a bit of a slower start here in the second period. Not too much action at either end. Most playing the neutral zone.
Arson back at the point. Dumps that one down to Hank. Arson now gets it back. Arson takes a wrist shot. That one's tipped. It was looks as though it was going in, but it was tipped high and wide.
Mustangs finally getting some traffic in front.
Probably one of the talking points for sure.
Yeah, it would have been a bit interesting to be in the locker rooms there in the intermission. Neither team really played too terribly in the first period there. So coaching staff probably saying just keep at it, boys, and get a bit more traffic, you would think.
Rocca goes for checking in hard. And it's going to be dumped out here by the Golden Hawks. Sinfeld sends that one in. Battle on the corner. Two Mustangs are on it. Arson. Now back around. Back to Bernard. Bernardi, he takes a shot. It's blocked and it goes wide of the net. And Rocca misses the puck. So it will go for an icing. It's then waved off. So coach didn't really like that call. Almost missing the puck there, whiffing at it. Nemeth and Eunice will now pick it up in behind the net. 16:03 remaining here in the second period. We're still scoreless. Nice deke in. In come the Stags. That one's trying to get a pass in front there. It was nicely blocked there by the Golden Hawks defender. Bellows. Try to get it out. He can't. Laurier desperately trying to get it out as Baker gets taken down for the Stags. He then goes to try to chase after it, but it'll be dumped out. Won't be enough for icing, though. Greenside wrapped out around the boards. Bellows leaves that one in front. And mid-up was there, but he couldn't do anything with it. Back out come the Stags. Sent in front. Snow is there. He tried another pass, but it went astray. Back out into the neutral zone. Snow misses it, but it will be no icing as he was over the red line already.
Both teams starting to pick up the pace in the second period here. 5 minutes in.
Snow with a wrist shot. Whips that high and wide. Smeet took that puck in the face there as it jumped up on him. And just like that, it's offside at the Laurier blue line. Or the Western blue line, however you want to look at it.
Faceoff coming up here in the neutral zone.
Faceoff won by Western. Smeet turns around.
Number 5 there, that looks to be Jason Swit. Oh, and it looks like Daniels took that one a bit funny. He's a bit slow getting up. But up he gets for the Golden Hawks after that save.
Want to join a winning team? Visit us at www.dominoslondon.ca. Get the door. It's Domino's.
Golden Hawks with the line change. Western electing to go with the players on the ice.
Jason Swit, he plays left defense. He's a 6'3 third year here at Western. He's from Mississauga, Ontario. He used to play for the PEI Rockets. As he keeps that puck in off the post there as Farmara tried to wrist shot there. Now Good comes out with the puck for the Golden Hawks. He tries a little dipsy doodle around the Western defense. There's in front. Shoots. No.
That will be waved off immediately.
No
the
goal.
Net had come
the net
off.
Was off.
Laurier attesting that the net came off after the goal to no avail.
So there will be a penalty to the Stangs for taking the net off in turn there, obviously, just because can't really do that.
I think the Golden Hawks would much prefer to have that goal allowed than go on the two-minute power play. But that is the call that is being made here.
Whether it was intentional or not, I guess the ref doesn't really look at that just because the puck had gone in the net. So we will see, I believe, Laurier's first penalty of the game or power play. And see Bernardi and Risk out there getting ready.
I believe they had an opportunity on the power play in the first period. Could be wrong. They'll have one now.
Bernardi is back at the point for the Golden Hawks. He gets the puck right now. Bernardi gets the puck back. He tries a slap shot. Whist on that one, though. Another slap shot. Blocked up in the air. Megastrail lost the puck there, and out come the Stangs. Baker on a breakaway. Baker in. Gets hooked. And no penalty on the play, as the coaches were livid about that one, but he did get a bit of a hook. Went in for the backhand. A great job there by Daniels to keep it out of the net.
Baker came streaking in on the penalty kill for the Mustangs. The Golden Hawk player behind him by a stride got the stick around the arm and prevented a goal. No penalty on the play as the faceoff is in the Laurier end. Laurier wins the faceoff. They'll continue behind the net.
Out come the Golden Hawks. Eunice leaves it there. He misses it though, and Greenside is back on the right side. Greenside, as Bells has it now. Greenside trying to get a stick on that putt to get it out. Fails at that though, and Bernardi sends it over to the left side. Bernardi once again.
Good setup here by the Laurier power play, looking for a chance.
Sinfeld just keeps that one in for the Golden Hawks. That one's sent in front. No one's there to put it home. Bernardi takes a slap shot. Great glove save there by Eunice, and he'll cover up and hang on with 35 seconds remaining in this Golden Hawks power play.
This game going a lot differently, as we said in the first intermission there, then their first matchup back on October 22nd, where the Mustangs were victorious with a 7-2 final score that night. Obviously 0-0 here in the second period of play. Looks to be a much closer contest tonight here at Thompson Arena.
Gauthier gets that one, sends it down to Alagok. Alagok loses that puck, and it's sent all the way down the ice, and that should just about do it for this Mustangs penalty kill, as Furlong's in there battling for the puck. Killing now saves the puck. In the neutral zone, they'll kill off the rest of this power penalty kill. That one goes right into the bench and hits one of the Laurier players. That was a Megastrail.
8 minutes into the second period of play here at Thompson Arena, with a face-off in the Golden Hawks zone. Western wins the face-off, back to defense.
That one loose in front, shoots off the post. That one just went wide of the net after it looked as though it took a nick off the post there, and that just about put the Western up 1-0. Now loose on the right side. There's a shot again saved by Daniels. And it goes wide of the net. Arson can't keep that one in. It'll go all the way down the ice. Sinfeld's there. Sorry, Skinner's there battling for Laurier. And out come the Stangs. Killing. Stops, wait for his men to come in. Turk Weiss loses that puck, and Snow's now battling for it in the corner. Snow sends that one back in front. Loose in front once again. There will be a penalty coming here to Laurier. Switz over to the right side.
The extra attacker on for Western.
Snow. Farmanara, who is that extra attacker, has his shot blocked. Goes over. Switz. Slap shot gets blocked into the corner. And now Laurier gains possession, and the penalty will be called for hooking.
That's going to be number four for the Golden Hawks. Mike Garthier. Garther. Sorry for the mispronunciation. He'll go 2 minutes.
So, Mustangs get another power play opportunity. Let's see if they can cash in on this one, as Arson can't keep that one in. Good ghost chasing after that one for Laurier. Sent in around the boards behind Eunice, and Arson will start out. Arson sends that one down the right-hand side for Furlong. He can't get it. Nemeth will have to backtrack.
Mike Gauthier taking the hooking penalty, I believe it was, for the Golden Hawks. He's a 6'4", second-year player from North Vancouver, BC, for the Golden Hawks.
Turquoise forechecking, and that helps as Arson keeps it in for Snow. Snow set over to the right-hand side, back to Snow. Snow gives it over to Turquoise, back to Arson. Arson over to Turquoise. Turquoise looking for the pass. He spins around. Turquoise, slap shot, goes, scores! Roof Daddy, nice shot there by Turquoise. 1-0 Western, and finally these fans at Rock the Rink 2011 have something to cheer about.
Turkowitz with the opening goal here at Thompson Arena to give the Mustangs a 1-0 lead on the power play. Let a shot go from the point and it found its way in. So the Mustangs up 1-0. Halfway through the second period of play here at Thompson Arena. Turkowitz with his 11th goal of the season. That's 22 points for him now on the year.
Sidamore, as the Stangs come back for more. Nemeth takes a stop shot. That one's blocked and goes into the corner. As the band's now in it, you can hear them playing some of their music. Getting these fans into this game now as they lead it 1-0. Puck is loose here for Laurier, but McQuaid will pick that one up.
Turkowitz, the goal scorer for the Mustangs from Brantford, Ontario. Previously played with the Belleville
McQuaid.
Bulls.
Sorry. McQuaid in front, backhand, and that one is blocked. So Turkowitz gets his crowd into it. Eunice leaves it here. He does a little bit of skating there. Leaves it there for Killing, who gets taken hard into the boards. No call on the play, though. There's a shot, gets blocked, goes all the way up, hits the roof, and comes back down onto the ice.
9 minutes left to play here in the second frame. Crowd has come alive with that goal from the Mustangs. Golden Hawks will be looking to rebound before the end of the period. Face-off in the Western zone.
This one's still, the net is off for Western, but Eunice will put that one back himself. Hannigan. Arson loses that puck, and out comes Laurier. There's a shot there by... That shot was by Skinner. He couldn't get a stick on it, though. Or no rebound, though, sorry. And Rocca now leaves it for his man. Hannigan takes a shot in front. Rocca almost put it home, but Daniels didn't know it, but he had it right underneath him. As Rocca was tangled up, he couldn't get a clean shot off.
Daniels with another great save there. He's had a few tonight for the Golden Hawks. He's definitely been a factor to this point.
Baker in to take the faceoff for the Stangs. He loses it, but Western will get possession right back as Snow sends it in around the boards. Bernardi sends it up into the neutral zone. And Snow will grab it for the Stangs. Snow dumps it in. Daniels will have to leave it there for his defenseman. That's Midup, who sent it to Good. Reed now. Back to Risk. Risk takes a shot.
And the net has come off just behind Eunice. There will be a face-off in the west, or they may take the face-off outside. We'll see here in a second. 7:52 left to play in the second period here as they replace the net. Or put it back in place, as should be saying.
So taking a look at your out-of-town OUA scoreboard, obviously it was 5-4 earlier where Windsor took over the game against the Western Mustangs ladies team. We watched that one earlier. And that was a great game to watch as Western comes right back out. Furlong grabs that one. And Reese loses it. Out comes Laurier. There's a shot in behind Eunice. He scrambles back into his net.
Eunice,
he's hurt.
Is down and not getting up very quickly. We'll have a pause here as the trainer comes out, as Eunice begins to regroup, and he is up. Got dumped into the crease there. Was one of the Golden Hawk players, I believe. Well, we have a moment here. Next weekend, big matchup for the Western Mustangs as they welcome Lakehead University to town for a doubleheader, a Friday and Saturday matchup. Both games here at Thompson Arena at 7:30 with puck drop. That will be another big matchup to go along following tonight's Rock the Rink event put on by Western University.
So it's 1-0 here, Western Mustangs taking the second period lead here over the Laurier Golden Hawks. And what's been a thriller of a game so far, so many chances, but the goalies have been standing strong today as Nemeth has the puck in behind the net. Dumps that around the boards. McQuaid sends it over to Nemeth. Nemeth can't control the puck and he'll lose it. In comes Laurier. In around behind the net.
Looks like there is a penalty coming up to Western as the Golden Hawks goalie retreats to the bench, and there's the whistle. It's going to be a holding penalty to Western.
It'll be a holding call to Sidamore.
Sidamore going off, it looks like. Nope, that is not going to be Sidamore. That will be, let's see here in a second. That's Josh McQuaid serving the 2 minutes for holding for Western. Got held up in his own zone. Or was holding up an opposing player in the zone. He'll serve 2 minutes. 7 minutes left in the second period here. Face off in the Mustang zone.
So Laurier has a chance to get back into this game. Alacock.
The Golden Hawks looking good on their earlier power play in the period. A bit of action in the Western end. Let's see if they can build on it to tie this game.
So McQuaid for holding at 13:01 is Sidamore, who was arguing with the ref. I thought he got the penalty, but he was actually the one arguing in favor of his teammate. So there was a bit of a collision there. Farmanara was taken out. It's cleared all the way down. Farmanara now picks it up. He takes a wrist shot. Great pad save there by Daniels. He had to be quick with his pad there. Now back into the Western zone. It's dumped down.
Just over a minute remaining in the power play for the Golden Hawks. The penalty kill looking strong once again for the Mustangs.
Bernardi takes a slap shot. That one gets blocked and goes out of play.
After they were able to score on their own power play, the Mustangs have slowed down a bit through the rest of the period. 1-0 here. 1 minute left on the power play for the Golden Hawks.
That one's kept in by Laurier. Bonneville gives that one to Bellows. Back to Bonneville. Bellows looking for a shot. He won't take it. There's a shot there by Bonneville. That one goes wide of the net. Bellows now regroups, setting up this power play. Bonneville takes a shot. That one's tipped in front. Not getting to Eunice, though. Bonneville now sends that one to Poulter, who takes a shot. That one's loose in front. That one's covered up, though, by Eunice. And there will be a face-off to the right of him with 22 seconds remaining here in that Western penalty kill.
Western Mustangs switching up their penalty kill units for the upcoming face-off in their own end.
So you're watching Rot the Rink 2011 Mustangs TV. If you're just joining us, it's 1-0 in favor of the Mustangs. I'm Andrew Buttigieg alongside Andrew Evans. My color commentator, Sinfeld, gives that one over. There's a wrist shot. That one's blocked nicely. And sent down the ice.
And that will just about wrap up the penalty kill for the Mustangs.
Out comes Farmanara. Sinamore. Farmanara just offside there, according to the linesman. The bench, though, had something else to say about that.
Josh McQuaid out of the penalty box after serving his two-minute penalty. Laurier Golden Hawks not able to take advantage of their power play. Another good, solid penalty kill from the Mustangs. Baker in to take the faceoff in the neutral zone.
They need one more player out. So Alacock takes the place out there for Laurier. Skinner loses the draw there for the Golden Hawks, and Bernardi will gain possession down on defense. Snow. Lost again by the Stangs. A few turnovers here late in this period as Eunice has to steer that one aside. It's in around behind the net. Into the corner. Looking to come out in front. There's a backhand shot attempt was fanned on. And out comes Western, has taken out hard there.
That looks to be Swit, who is dumped in the neutral zone. We'll get a whistle here as the trainer comes out to attend.
No, it's going to be Snow.
Oh, that looks to be Snow, correct?
No. Sorry. Yes, it is Swit.
Swit back to the bench, and we'll have a face-off in the neutral zone.
Sorry, no, it is Snow. My mixing you up there.
Snow back to the bench for the Mustangs. Looks to be quite fine. He'll rest it off on the bench as the Mustangs lose the faceoff in the neutral zone with just over 4 minutes remaining in the second period.
Arson picks that one up in his own zone. He'll send that one up. McKee, he loses it momentarily but picks it right back up. Rocca needs to get back onside so he can't apply the forecheck. Arson loses the puck or can't get to the puck. So it'll go right back to Eunice. He almost gets taken out by Laurier forward. Megastrail sent that one into the Western zone, but again, nothing doing here for Laurier so far. It's 1-0 Western, but Western seems to be sitting back a bit more. I haven't seen a chance from them in quite a while. Magistrail loses the puck. Rocca picks it right back up. Nice deke. There's a shot off the side of the net. Rocca will spin right back around. He's a force. He does a ton of things for this team. You know, his stats might not look good, but he hasn't been with the team the entire year. So Rocca will be a great strength. He's very big and very good goal scorer. I know he topped the St. Thomas Stars in goal scoring in years past.
Just offside there. We'll have another face-off. 2:49 left to play in the period.
Furlong. The Furlong brothers are back out on the ice now. And what do you know? They're numbers 21 and 22. So nothing better than that. Reese can't control the puck. It's in front. Bernardi with a shot. That one's blocked. Rebound in front. Will be covered up by Eunice. 2:26 remaining here in the second period. It's 1-0 Stangs.
Another nice save from Eunice there, who was shaken up earlier in the period. Does not look to be feeling the ill effects of that incident, as there will be a face-off to his right side.
Face-off won by Western. Will be dumped out. Farmanara is trying to pick that one up. Will be dumped down into the Laurier zone. Well, they'll pick it up. Bonneville in around behind the net. Bonneville coming out in front, scoops that one out in front. Nothing doing there for Laurier as there was no one on the doorstep. Williams down there battling for Laurier. Once again, they'll lose the puck, and out comes Simidor. Just offside once again. They've been caught a couple of times. Farmanara, this time the culprit, getting into the zone just a bit too early. He was trying to get back, but not in time.
Just under the two-minute mark here. Laurier, Golden Hawks possibly looking to finish the period on a stronger note after giving up a goal earlier in the period. Mustangs win the faceoff in the neutral zone.
Taken down there, and there will be a penalty coming up here as Killing was taken down. Eunice races to the net, and Western will control here, trying to do something with their sixth attacker. Baker scoops that one over to Snow. Snow, and this one's going to be dumped in as Killing goes after it. Killing wraps that one back. In front it goes.
And the whistle on the upcoming two Laurier Gold Hawks. That will be number 8. Thomas Midup from Richmond Hill, Ontario, serving 2 minutes. Did not see what the call was for, but I believe it was a trip in the neutral zone.
Or a hold, it could be two, I'm not sure. Either way, he got him wrapped up and took him down in the neutral zone.
With 1:17 left here in the second period.
Eunice will leave it there. Skinner goes racing after it. It's going to be a hook. Not a trip, not a hole. So we were both called.
So the Knights will see, or the Mustangs, mind you, sorry, will see an extended power play go into the third period, start the third frame.
Swit takes a shot. That one saved as an earlier shot had gone off the post.
And some pushing and shoving in front of the net. Nothing too serious. 47 seconds now remaining in the second period. 1:30 left in the power play for the Mustangs. You don't know it. Baker will take the faceoff in the Laurier end.
Baker loses the faceoff there to Risk. Swit can't keep it in. It'll go all the way down the ice with 40 seconds remaining here in the second period.
Eunice playing that one behind the net.
Out comes Western. Maybe one last attack here in this period. Killing gets tripped up there. No penalty on the play. He goes diving all the way into the Laurier zone. Risk will pick it up here on a breakaway. Risk in. Shoots. Great. Pad save there by Eunice. He took the net off. And there was a bit of pushing, shoving, and stuff after the whistle. Eunice even getting involved. As Gauthier even gave Eunice a little bump as well.
Net coming off on that play after the breakaway. Another great stop by Eunice as the net came off. Possibly from the leg kick of Eunice to keep this game in favor of the Mustangs. 1-0 with 18 seconds left in the period.
That would have been a backbreaker for sure going into the second period. You would think up 1-0, especially if they're on a power play right now. But that breakaway there just about had Laurier tied up. But Eunice has stayed strong in net all game. Poulter loses that draw there for Laurier. It'll be sent out with 13 seconds remaining. It'll go for an icing, so Laurier will have one more chance to possibly do something in the Western zone. faceoff won by Western. Nemeth.
And that'll just about do it for the second period of play as time will wind down, leaving 43 seconds on the power play to start the third period for the Mustangs. So after the middle frame here at Thompson Arena, the score is 1-0 for the Mustangs off that power play goal earlier in the second period by Keaton Kirkowitz. He was able to capitalize on the scoring opportunity, put the Mustangs up 1-0 here at Thompson Arena.
So we're just about gonna wait for Kathleen Campbell-Conlon, who's got a Western Mustang player down. At the end, just waiting for her to grab a player.
That looks to be Turkowitz that Kathleen will be interviewing momentarily.
Seem to be having some technical difficulties with the cameras. Can't seem to get it on, which is fine. We may just have to So our first period, second period of play comes to an end, and a
quite the period we had there, Andrew? Early power play goal.
That's what we're trying to do. When we got the power play, everyone was just saying put pucks to the net. So came around, took one. Luckily, it went in. So
now, Laurier, coming into this game, they're like a middle-seeded team. Did you expect it to be this tough going into the second?
Yeah, they always come out hard against us, especially coming into the new year. Playoffs are going to be here in no time. So every team we're going to be playing now is going to be coming hard, and it's no different for Laurier.
All right, so you hold the lead now. What are you guys going to keep doing, or what are you going to do better to maintain this for the next period?
We got to pick it up. They're coming. We're kind of turning the puck over in our own end. It's a matter of time before they score if we continue to do that. So we just got to be better defensively, get the pucks in low on their end, and I'm sure we'll get a couple more.
Great. Thanks so much, Keaton. Good luck on the next period. And with that, it is 1-0 for the Western Mustangs at the end of the second period. Back up to you guys at the booth.
I'm the loudest.
So taking back a look at our second period summary. Sorry, we couldn't get Kathleen Campbell-Conlon on the interview. We're having some technical difficulties with that camera down there. But Andrew, wrap up what our goal scorers for this second period. There was only one.
Yeah, that would be Keaton Turkowitz on the early power play for the Mustangs there in the second period. He was able to fire home a shot from just inside the blue line, I believe it was, maybe closer to the circle, and got past the Laurier goaltender, who has played exceptionally so far, but could not make the save on that one. Ryan Daniels definitely keeping the Golden Hawks in the game so far. Plenty of great saves from him. Same could be said for Josh Yunus of the Mustangs, who is also showing up tonight for the Mustangs.
So let's send it to a break. We'll watch, let you guys watch the second intermission and all of its happenings. There's going to be a Chuck Puck, and they're trying to find a super fan right now. We'll be back with some more Mustangs TV and Mustangs hockey. We'll be right back. Thanks so much for tuning in. We'll be right back with the third period right after this.
Thank you, everyone, to be with you so good. And if you want to come with me, please back Western Road. Thank you, Richard Wilson. And we're watching behind an annual weather market. Congratulations to tonight's super fans. Shots in the second period of 41-96 in favor of the Laurier Golden Hawks. For an overall shot total of 18. Summary. to the shut the puck booth to claim your prize.
Welcome back to Thompson Arena. Welcome back to Rock the Rink. Welcome back to some OUA Western Mustangs action. Western Mustangs taking on the Laurier Golden Hawks. Coming in here for the third period, the Golden Hawks will have a man less on the ice, as so Western's going to have a power play for 43 seconds or less, depending on if they strike early here in the third. And definitely a big third period. But do you keep on applying the pressure, Andrew Evans, if you're the Western Mustangs?
Oh, definitely. In a 1-0 game, you have to even step up a notch. It's great that they're starting on the power play. They were able to go up 1-0 on a power play goal in this second there from Keaton Turkowitz. He mentioned to halftime or intermission reporter Kathleen Campbell-Conlin that they need to get after it and work a bit harder in the period. So 43 seconds left on power play to start the period, and yeah, definitely.
And after that goal, after that goal in the second period, it seemed like they were just lying back just a little bit, so maybe they need to apply the pressure a bit more than they were before. Nemeth has it down at the blue line. He loses the puck. That one's dumped out. There will be 20 seconds remaining here in this 5-on-4 man advantage for the Mustangs. That one sent cross ice here. Puck bouncing a bit here on the fresh ice as Poulter skates in, but that goes offside.
And unfortunately, it doesn't look like the Mustangs were able to take advantage of that early power play. 9 seconds left. With the score only 1-0, that undefeated streak that the Mustangs have coming into this one, 13-0-3 coming in, and a 1-0 lead is never safe. So they'll continue play. Oh, dumped in the neutral zone there. And the power play is officially over.
Laurier wanted offside there, but that won't happen as that one's sent in front. Going into the net there is Killing, and it'll be called. And a coach is still yelling at the ref for what should have been, or what he thought should have been, an offside.
If you're just joining us, the score is 1-0 for the Western Mustangs over the Laurier Golden Hawks inside the first minute of the third period here at Rock the Rink 2011. Great crowd on hand, great activities going on around the rink. Overall, a great success for the Mustangs who have organized this great event.
Losing the faceoff there was Baker, and out comes Laurier. Williams takes a wrist shot. That one goes high and wide over above Eunice. Arson had that one bounce off the boards weirdly, and out comes Turkowitz. Turkowitz tries to get back by his man. He can't. Killing dumps that one in. Snow is after it. Snow tries to take a wrist shot from a very sharp angle. That one gets blocked, though. Out comes the Golden Hawks. Bellows dumps that one in. Eunice couldn't glove that one out of midair, and it's sent right back in front. Eunice has his skate against the post, and he'll cover up with 18:33 remaining here in the third period.
Line change here for the Mustangs, as there will be a face-off in their own end.
Face off won by Laurier.
Mustangs pick it up in their own zone and through the neutral zone. That's McQuaid firing a shot over the net.
Back comes Laurier. Poulter gets stopped there by the linesman. And into the zone it goes. Nice hit there by one of the Stangs defenders. Wraparound shot, scores!
Laurier Golden Hawks tie the game at one.
Skinner on that one, puts that one in. A little bit of action after the whistle, but just like that, we have ourselves a tight game.
That's all it takes in a 1-0 game. Just one shot, and all of a sudden we have a tie game, and the tide has turned. Alexander Poulter with the goal there for the Golden Hawks. I think that may have been Skinner. None of the matter. Golden Hawks in the neutral zone.
Nemeth sends that one cross ice as now the Mustangs need to pick it up here. They see themselves end their undefeated streak. Just a bit tad
at stake, I think you could. With 17 minutes and 34 seconds left in the tie game, that undefeated streak, of course, is just regulation, having dropped three games in overtime this year. I think they would like to avoid the extra frame. And a good chunk of time left to do that.
Nemeth is back at the line. He takes a wrist shot. Goes untouched wide of the net. Furlong battling for that puck. That's Sean Furlong. He lost the handle on it. It's sent right back in there by Nemeth. Laurier will gain possession. Van de Basport, probably one of the longest names on Laurier's team. I dumped that one in, but it goes offside.
Wholesale changes for both teams as fresh legs come out on the ice for the faceoff in the neutral zone. Golden Hawks winning that one.
Killing sends that one into the corner. Turkowitz tries to deke. He gets tripped up. There will be a penalty coming. Loose in front there was Snow. He couldn't get a stick on it. And now here comes the penalty. It will be a tripping call to Laurier.
And I'm not too sure about that one. It looked more to be a shoulder-to-shoulder hit. The Laurier Golden Hawk player explaining his side of it to no avail. That looks to be number 8 for the Golden Hawks. Thomas mid up, heading to the box. A little unhappy with the call. He'll serve 2 minutes for the trip. And we'll have a face-off in the Golden Hawks zone.
Baker loses that one, and just like that, sent down to Eunice. We'll have to leave that one there.
Mustangs carry it through the neutral zone and into the Golden Hawks end. And a little tap shot on net for a face-off.
Risk will take the face-off here for Laurier. Baker will take it for Western to the right of Daniels. Scrum face-off goes back to the point. Killen. Back bounced off the boards to Baker. That one goes to Reese, but it will be blocked and out into the neutral zone. McKee. Nice move there around the Laurier defenseman in front. And lifted the stick, there was the Laurier defenseman. Killing. Now Reese in the corner. Killing's back at the point. He stops it, sends it cross ice. That one once again gets blocked as Laurier is getting in front of these passes. and doing well here on the penalty kill today.
1 minute left in the power play for the Mustangs.
Reese.
Not able to set anything up so far.
That one's back to the point. Killing with the slap shot. He fanned on it, and out comes Laurier. Williams will kill some more time. And he'll be slapped all the way down onto Eunice. He'll have to make a save on that one. Now come
Golden Hawks penalty kill looking very strong once again. Making up for the power play goal from the Mustangs in the second period. Quick shot on net there to the corner.
Snow gets taken out there. Taking a couple of weird bounces off these boards here today. Arson keeps it in though. Sent right back to Arson. Power play just about over. Taken out there from behind and shut down the ice. And that will do it for this Laurier penalty kill. Farmanar will tip that one in and go off. No, he'll stay on.
Mustangs need to step up their special teams here in the third period. Started the period on a short 43-second power play. We're unable to muster any offense. And again, have wasted away 2 minutes in this tie game in the third period with 14:30 left to play.
Poulter has the loose puck. He tries a shot. He gets blocked. Back behind the net. Wraparound shot. Loose in front. There's a shot. Once again blocked. Eunice didn't have to make a save there. Big hit there along the board by Aliska. Magistrail will skate out here for Laurier. Sent cross ice. Risk couldn't get to that one. Now it's here for Bonneville. Bonneville takes a shot. Nice pad save there by Eunice. It's quick with those pads. McKee now has himself stripped there of the puck. Back in come the Golden Hawks. A floater of a shot goes high and wide. And another shot. This time going out of play there by Shepley.
Face off here in the neutral zone.
Williams wins the face-off, but it hit someone in the bench there as they were trying to dump it in. And it'll go right back to where it was before with a face-off just outside of the Western Territory. Furlong wins the face-off. Guard back to Paltridge, who gets across ice. Trying to spring mid up there. To no avail, and out comes Furlong for the Stangs. He had his first shot blocked and now goes into the corner. Reese, I believe, lost his stick there.
He has regained it. The Golden Hawks come into the western zone.
Gauthier takes a shot. That one's blocked there nicely by Killing.
With just over 12 and a half minutes left to play, I tell you what, the Mustangs definitely need a momentum switch to get things going, and they have a quick dump shot on net there. Face off coming up in the Laurier end. Line changes for both teams.
Face-off won by Western. That goes into the corner and in behind the net. Magistrail sends that one up ice. In comes Skinner. Skinner with a wrist shot. Nice blocker saved there by Eunice. Right back comes Western. 2-on-2. Farmanara looking for a wrist shot. He takes it just off the shoulder there of Daniels. That's the first save he's had to make in quite a while. McQuaid now with a shot. And Daniels, once again, covers up.
line changes for both teams here. Keeping the legs fresh in a 1-1 game here with 12:09 left in the third period at Thompson Arena. Your Western Mustangs taking on the Golden Hawks, who have just won a faceoff at their own end.
Kept in there by Greenside. Turkowitz missed the puck, sent in front there. Goes back to Nemeth. Nemeth can't keep it in though, and it's back to Greenside. He'll dump it right back in. Wraps it around the board. Took a weird bounce in front, but no one was there for Western to cash in. Out comes the captain. Risk. He has his first shot blocked. He then gets it back. Couldn't do anything with the second opportunity. Snow now gets the puck for Western. He dumps it into to Turkowitz. He's late getting there, and back comes the Golden Hawks. Shepley, a spin around there. Now Turkowitz needs to catch up to a loose puck. He does. Turkowitz tries a shot on net. That one's blocked, goes into the corner. Back out in front. No one can put it home. And back out comes Laurier. Once again, back and forth it goes.
Ray. Mustangs through the neutral zone.
Ray was chasing down a Mustangs forward. That was Switt. And with 10:50 remaining, we'll have a whistle and a bit of a scrum as well.
Both teams looking to pick up an edge on one another here in the third period of a tie game. Both teams come in riding undefeated streaks. Of course, the Mustangs with their season-long undefeated streak, while the Golden Hawks are undefeated in six games. So with just over 10 minutes remaining in the third period in the tie game, both streaks are at risk.
Furlong. The two Furlong brothers are in. There's a backhand shot. That one's gloved there by Daniels. And Laurier will regroup. Out they come. Williams. Fellows couldn't reach that loose puck, and Reese now will come back. Furlong. Looking cross ice. He had that one blocked, but Killing will grab it. In front of Furlong. Shot. He runs into the goaltender. And there will be a whistle here. No penalty, I don't think, though.
Nope, that looked to be accidental contact. That stayed on its hinges. And we will have a face-off in the Golden Hawk zone.
Matamore scrums the face-off there, and McQuaid was there trying to get after a loose puck. In front, loose in front there was Farmanara. He couldn't put anything home though. Killing now left that one for Matamore. Simador in front couldn't do anything with it. Again sent in front. Simador couldn't put it home. Farmanara now with a shot. Blocker saved there by Daniels. And that one sent all the way down the ice as Arson couldn't keep that one in. But it will go for an icing with 9:29 remaining here in the third period. 1-1.
Well, buddy gig, boy oh boy, with 9:29 left here in the third period, 1-1 hockey game.
Should be in for a barn burner of a finish. Nemeth is back at the point. Someone sent around the boards, back to Snow. Snow has his pass deflected and will get out. Sends that one to Nemeth. Nemeth will dump that one right back in as Western is trying to apply some pressure here late. in front. Snow's there. He couldn't get to the loose puck. Nima takes a slap shot. That one's blocked. Turkowitz. Now taking a out hard against the boards there. Was Baker. He takes a shot. That one almost fooled the goaltender. Turkowitz couldn't get to the loose puck. Now he does. He's grabbed onto. He falls.
Whoa, that's a bit of a shot to the head of Mustangs player. A bit of a scrum now. That will definitely, I would think, result in a penalty. We'll see what the referees have to say after this one is sorted out. It looked as though a Golden Hawks player took a bit of a shot at a Mustang player who is down on the ice. Does not look like there will be any penalty call on the play, but there will be a face-off in the Golden Hog zone.
Reese is going to take the face-off for Western. He wins it. It goes straight on net. Daniels had to be quick. Reese now sends it in front. No one's there. Paltridge now sends it to the left side. There's a wrist shot. That one goes wide of the net. Laurier trying to get it out and says backhanded. And Reese gets an opportunity to center it. But once again, no Mustang is there to put home the loose puck. Paltridge up to Furlong. And the other Furlong loses the puck and it'll be sent in by Laurier. Bellows. Mid up now, giving a little shot to the head to Furlong. Sinfeld, he sends it down low. Looking for a centering opportunity, he does. No shot on net though. Here comes Furlong. Furlong with a wrist shot. Daniels covers up. 7:30 remaining here. Third period of play. Rock the Rink 2011. 1-1 game. You couldn't ask for anything else. Pat Darina.
Well, from a Mustang point of view, you could ask for a lead here in the third period to ensure that undefeated streak stays intact. A bit of work left to do for that to happen.
That will put the icing on the cake to what has been a great night here at Thompson Arena. They've seen a thriller of a game. Now they just need... It looks as though McQuaid has something stuck on his jersey. It looks like a ponytail almost.
Yeah, he definitely lost the strap on the helmet, possibly. Yeah, it looks to be the neck guard. Came undone. They'll get that readjusted on the bench as play continues.
Farmanara is racing down the right-hand side. He'll get the puck, but he loses it, and back quickly come the Golden Hawks. No one's dumped in. Poulter needs a change, and Eunice will leave it there. Out come the Stags. Turkowitz. He's the man with the goal so far today. Sent in front to Snow. Snow with a shot that goes wide of the net. Here's Reed now. That one's backhanded there by Good, but to the wrong person, as now there's going to be a face-off inside of Western Zone for a net, the net coming off.
Both teams getting ready for the face-off in the neutral zone. Neither team really getting after it to this point. Mustangs dump that one through the neutral zone and the Golden Hawks pick it up.
Here's Nemeth. He loses the puck. That one's dumped in there by Marsden.
6 minutes remaining here. And the game is still very much up for grabs. Not one team outplaying the other. It is clearly in the hands of the taker.
Out comes Laurier. Ray takes a shot. That one is saved by Eunice. Once again, a little bit of after whistle activity here. Nothing will come out of it though, and the faceoff will come inside of the Western zone.
Looking towards next weekend, of course, as time winds down here in the third period of a 1-1 game, we will mention a big matchup next Friday and Saturday night here at Thompson Arena. Your Western Mustangs taking on Lakehead.
There's a shot there that goes wide the net. Wraparound try, that net comes off.
And a broken stick on the ice. That looks to be belonging to Reese, number 11 for the Mustangs. We'll have another face-off to the left of Eunice, 5:36 remaining.
Furlong wins the face-off. Western will try to get it out. Instead, that's dumped right back in. Kept in there by Bellows. Bellows turns around, takes a shot. That one handcuffed Eunice, but it goes wide of the net. Mid-up trying to poke the puck free. He got taken down there by Furlong, who actually thought he was going to get a penalty by his reaction, but no hand goes up there by the ref. Furlong over to Reese. He tries a shot that gets blocked. Furlong now back. Gives it to Reese. Reese centers in front. Runs a bit of an interference on the goalie, but no call. Bellows back the other way. He takes a wrist shot off the crossbar. Sharp angle shot. Great shot it was, though, trying to pick a corner. Nice, nifty move there. In, backhand, scores!
That will count as the net did come off after the goal. And we have a 2-1 lead for the Mustangs.
Great goal there. Great move. Reese dips it utiling around the entire Laurier team, including the goalie. The net did come off, but there will be
Steve Reese puts the second goal of the game.
Now the referees are talking about it in front of the penalty box here. Farmanara and Risk are both going over to see what the refs have to say about it.
Either way, I was about to mention that the Golden Hawks had stepped up play a bit.
Goal.
And no goal! They have called this one back. It appears the net did in fact come off prior to the goal. And this one is quite controversial.
I agree.
So Steve Reese walked through the team, it looked like. Came around through the neutral zone. Looked as though he had put the Mustangs ahead with 4:42 left to play in the third period here. Unfortunately, after discussions amongst the officials, that does not appear to be the case. Western Mustang players continue to discuss.
Everybody clap your hands. Clap, 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 clap your hands.
And it looks like we have a slight delay in action here.
There's going to be a penalty to Laurier for taking the net off in turn. So, they need to send someone to the box
to be the case.
Gauthier will go off for Laurier. Risk and Farmanara will take the faceoffs for each team.
And maybe that's just the spark that the Mustangs need. After having one called off just seconds ago, they will have 2 minutes on the power play with 4:30 left in the third period here at Thompson Arena. The game had begun to drag on, and you know what? A spark may have been lit here. Let's see if the Mustangs can take advantage.
Nemeth, as Farmanara takes a bit of a spill on his own end. Arson dumps that one in. Again, that net comes off. But Daniels puts it right back on. Nemeth now sends it to the left side. Back to Nemeth. Nemeth down low. Gets it right back again. Nemeth sends it down into the corner. Back to Arson. Arson now takes a one-timer slap shot. Daniels there. He saw that one all the way.
Just over a minute left of power play time for the Mustangs. Face-off upcoming in the Golden Hog zone of Ryan Daniels. Baker in to take the draw for the Mustangs.
Baker loses the draw. Goes into the corner as two Mustangs are there battling for it. That one's ripped around the boards to Arson. Reese now. Gives it back to Killing. Killing to Baker. Baker winds up. Sent back in front. One-timer goes wide of the net. He had the whole left side of that net open. And he just fanned on that one. Eunice will leave it for Killing. Killing slaps that one into the zone. As Reese is back out on the ice, he's obviously looking for some redemption, having his goal called off. And this might be advantage Laurier, having their a goal called off for Western and maybe even Killing this power play.
It looks as though that will happen. Whistle upcoming. And did that puck? No.
And they want an intentional offside. They want to go all the way back down into the Western zone. Instead, they'll come right outside the Laurier blue line.
8 seconds remaining in the power play for the Mustangs. Unable to take advantage. And in fact, faceoff will come down towards the Western Mustangs end. Either way, in the neutral zone. 8 seconds remaining in that power play with 2:50 left to play in the third period of a 1-1 game.
That one slapped in by Shepley. Hannigan is waiting for his team to get all organized. Sidamore. That one's dumped into the corner. Farmanara. Now trying to battle for it along the boards. He loses it. Out comes Laurier. Bellows. There's a wrist shot. Nice save there by Eunice. It looks as though it handcuffed him, though, and got him right up near the neck area.
2:09 here in the third period. And it looks as both teams, as I said earlier in the period, no one really getting after it after the Western Mustangs goal was called off moments ago.
Face-off won by Laurier. Gauthier takes a shot, scores! Oh my! That turns the tables a bit.
Does it ever? With 2:04 left to play in the third period, the Laurier Golden Hawks have scored the go-ahead goal. Skinner with the marker, and the Western Mustangs' undefeated streak in regulation so far this season is definitely in doubt. So that's number 38, Benjamin Skinner, with the go-ahead marker for the Laurier Golden Hawks. 2 minutes left to play.
That was obviously a tip-in. Original shot there by Gauthier. Turkowitz now. Western has some coming back to do now. Turkowitz skates in. Eunice will keep an eye on him for you. Now there's going to be a penalty coming up here to Laurier.
Take down just behind the Laurier net. And now you keep an eye on Eunice in the between the pipes for the Mustangs.
And I wouldn't doubt if I see a timeout.
Yep, a possible timeout here. I think that's what we may have. Yes, he has called the timeout. So the Western Mustangs, down 2-1 in the third period with 1:44 left, have gone on a 2-minute power play in the undefeated streak in regulation time. This season is definitely in doubt. Now Andrew, with 2 minutes left of 2 minutes power play time, 1:43, I believe, left in regulation. Would you think about possibly pulling Eunice at some point during this power play to get the two-man advantage in hopes of tying the game?
Most definitely. Most definitely. Whether it's right now, I doubt it. It's maybe just a bit too early. One, two, three, four, five. They do have six attackers
Eunice
right now.
Eunice will be on the bench there, yep. They will go with six attackers.
I don't blame them. Six attackers, 1:44. You have a full 2 minutes of power play time. The rest of the game, might as well. You're down one goal. Killing at the point. Gets that one over to Arson. Arson sends that one down. Arson just keeps that one in. As Turkowitz had his pass go astray. Snow back to Killing. Killing down low to Baker. Here's Turkowitz over to Killing. He gets it right back. Killing over to Arson. Arson back to Killing. Killing looking for a shot. Takes the pass instead. He now gets back to the point. Killing looking to wind up. Gets it back down low. Sent in front. Arson slap shot. Shoots. Good save there by Daniels with a whole bunch of traffic in front. And that's what you need to do on this power play. Minute 05 remaining here in this penalty. Sorry, not in the penalty, in the period.
As we mentioned, Western Mustangs coming into this game with the record of 13-0-3. No losses in regulation time. I'm sure that may be sitting in the back of the minds of the players right now. Obviously, no one expects an undefeated season in regulation time.
Hard hit
behind the boards. No call on that one. That one continues.
Wrapped around the boards and out as Killing has to retreat back, and Turkowitz will skate right back in. He gets, good job there by, I believe that was Arson. Yes, Arson, who just probably saved a goal there as that one was going down into the Stang zone, and he gloved that one to stop it from going anywhere near the net. Turkowitz and Farmanara are battling there. Bit of a cross check, lots of cross checks going, and the fans, another cross check, and the fans and the coaches want a penalty here. 23 seconds remaining. Arson can't keep it in.
And with 15 seconds left, Mustangs need something to happen real quick here.
Arson gets that one up. Snow down the right side in front. 7 seconds remaining. Baker tries to center it. He can't. Now there's a penalty coming up, but there's only 3 seconds left.
One last chance for the Mustangs to keep their undefeated regulation streak alive. Gonna need a bit of a miracle here in this one.
This is a
couple line changes here for the final play of the game.
Kyle Van de Bosport is taking his time to get to the bench or to the penalty box. Probably wants to give his penalty killers a bit of time. They need a quick shot quick, and that one goes into the corner, and that will do it. There goes Western's undefeated streak, and there goes Laurier, winners of this one, 2-1, in what was a great game with a lot of controversy.
Yeah, definitely some tricky calls there. But hey, at the end of the day, hats off to the visiting Laurier Golden Hawks. I know that's not something many of you want to hear, but they came into Thompson Arena on Rock the Rink night, and they got it done. I mean, there was the goal called off for the Mustangs earlier in the period, but it is what it is. And as you said, the Western Mustangs' undefeated streak in regulation is out the window. Number 38 for the Golden Hawks, Benjamin Skinner, nets the game winner to give the Golden Hawks the victory tonight to improve to 10-4-4 on the year, while the number 4 Western Mustangs will drop to 13-1-3 heading into next week's action.
So, let's hope this time we can get Kathleen Campbell-Conlon down at ringside.
It looks like she's going to try to grab one of the Mustang players to discuss the final result of tonight's game.
And she's actually waiting for the one person that's still on the ice discussing with the referee.
Nothing wrong with a bit of post-game chatter amongst players and officials just to clear up any miscommunications from the game.
It's going to be Scott Arson we're going to get a word from. So Scott Arson, let's get a word from him with Kathleen Campbell-Conlon down at ringside. Kathleen, take it away.
All right, we're here with assistant captain Scott Arson. That was a tough loss.
Yeah, we hate to lose, and especially at home in front of all these fans, it's tough. But, you know, both teams played a hard game, and they came out on top. They scored on their chances, and that's the difference.
Now let's just talk about that one goal that it was in. Everyone thought it was in, and just, you know, it got called off. Like, what happened down there?
The way the referee described it, the net went off before the puck went in the net, so he had a penalty called on them already. And so after the whistle went, they had a penalty to them. We got a power play, and that was his explanation. Net was off already. So.
All right, but now you got to look ahead. You got huge rivals, Lakeheads, coming down here for back-to-back games. You know, how are you feeling going into this? They're tough.
Yeah, you know, they're a big rival of ours, and they always play hard, always play us well. But, you know, we just got to do the best we can to prepare. And, you know, we didn't play too bad. I mean, we could play better for sure, but just got to have a good week of practices coming up here and just keep pushing.
Great. Thanks so much, Scott. Thanks for everything. Good job. And with the final score of 2-1, the Wilfrid Laurier Golden Hawks take the win. Back to you guys in the booth.
Thanks so much, Kathleen, and thanks so much to everyone for tuning in to this Western Mustangs hockey game. Both men's and women's faced off today at Rock the Rink.